Yo, so what's going on, Battlefoot? My name is Postar, and we are back with another gameplay. Today, we're rushing around on Domovan Peak. I've got the M27 IAR out, because you know that's my favorite loadout for this map. There are a few things that I want to point out during the gameplay to give you guys a few tips and tricks, things that I love to do when I plant the objective, great locations to cover it from. So make sure you pay attention to the gameplay. But anyways, we're here to talk about dreams. Good dreams, bad dreams, wet dreams, and everything in between. Oh, I'm excited for this. Let's fast mode this up a little bit. It's a little boring, you know. The long walk across this map can be just, it's crazy, man. What if I pulled like a hamstring or something? It's just not unnecessary. But anyways, I want to talk to you guys about dreams. And more specifically right now, this was fueled by a nightmare I had the other day. Now, I don't get nightmares too much now that I'm an adult. When I was a kid, I got them all the time. I used to watch, you know, horror movies. I was obsessed with horror movies as a child. I got into video games watching very, very scary games. My father used to play Doom. If you guys were around during that age and you were a Doom baby, my father used to play this, and I used to have nightmares. And these were like consecutive nightmares. I remember the guy with the rocket on his arm, the big boss guy or whatever. And I remember him, you know, I would always play out. I'd be on the map, I'd be running through, it'd be real time, and he'd always kill me. And I'd always wake up crying every day. And I had nightmares, as in they were like consecutive, like every day for like 2 weeks straight I'd have a nightmare, then I'd have one solid, you know, dream or whatever, and then I'd be back and watching Nightmare, and then my dad started playing Resident Evil and playing, you know, Resident Evil 2, which was I think the best one, and then Nemesis, and I started having nightmares about Resident Evil, like when you spawn in there trying to find the green herbs and everything. So everything was so realistic, but as a kid it was simple. I mean, I think you were more afraid of things as a child, so you dealt with a lot more, many more nightmares, if you see. Now as an adult, you know, I think we deal with fantasies more than anything now, you know what I mean? We deal with things that we want rather than things that we're afraid of. We're more mature now, we're more understanding of the realistic side of, you know, Nemesis coming through a wall and beating my shit in half. I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon, but, you know, I think nightmares and dreams are, they're just magical things, man. They're incredible, and they used to scare the hell out of me when I was a child, and I guess I like to see how things have changed since I was a kid. You know, I used to have nightmares all the fucking time. I never dreamt about anything that I looked forward to or had fun with or anything like that. So I guess the situation, the scenario was that I had a really, really rough nightmare the other day, and this nightmare was different, because nightmares change. You know, you're afraid of things happening, you know, being bit by a stingray or something. I don't even think I have teeth, but that's the kind of fucking nightmares I used to have. I used to be afraid of everything as a child, but now you're more afraid. You know, my nightmares, when I die in a nightmare, I don't care. It's like, you know what, I'm just going to hit that respawn button in 3 seconds anyways. I'm going to spawn on my fire team, buddy. It's whatever. You know, when I die in a thing that doesn't wake me up anymore, it doesn't scare me. When I wake up, I'm not, you know, in a wreck the next morning sweating balls. You know, it's not anything like that. It's more along the lines of, you know, your family's involved now. Now you're trying to survive the zombie apocalypse, or you know, somebody comes and breaks into your house and kills your loved ones or something like that. I mean, they change so drastically, like, from being a kid, because it was just so simple, you know. You're just Mario Brothers type, basic, standard, childish type dreams and fantasies and everything like that. And when it comes down to being an adult, you more fear for the loved ones' lives. That's what wakes me up. That's what messes me up, is when a dream feels so real, a nightmare feels so real, and you have the emotions, and you wake up with your heart pounding, the intensity, and you feel like, you know, oh my God, and it snaps back to realism, and you're like, oh shit, okay, everybody's alive, everything's okay, I didn't fail that drop shot in the hallway, and, you know, my wife didn't die, you know, that kind of shit, you know what I mean? But sometimes, I guess they're kind of like grained inside of us, like our fantasies, our dreams, our possibilities, our futures, what we think, what we'd actually do. Like, I had a dream one time about the zombie apocalypse, and I woke up the next day. You know, I played it out. It played out like a Walking Dead type scene thing, where I went to Walmart, stocked up on stuff, found a gun store, you know, the standard stuff. But this was a dream. It's like I wasn't playing it out. It was a movie. It was happening. You know what I mean? It was actually happening. But when I woke up and I thought it through, and I'm like, you know what? If I was actually in that situation, I would have probably done that exact fucking thing. So I think it's like unconsciously doing something. It's like your decision was made, and that's how it would have played out in real life. Look at me. This is a great way to defend B out here. Great way to do this. Great cover. Nobody knows you're here. Perfect tip for you guys. But anyways, back on track. So I had this nightmare the other day, and I call it a nightmare. It wasn't necessarily a fear, and the Slenderman didn't come out of nowhere and, you know, slip the old ding-dong in my butt, mum. But it was more along the lines of, you know, losing a loved one kind of thing. And It was different because this was a different one. Usually, my nightmares consist of like losing my wife or something with my, you know, child or mother or something like that, and me failing to protect them. That's generally what my nightmares are, and that's I rarely remember my dreams and nightmares. I mean, my nightmares are usually the ones that I remember most. I don't dream of, you know, general stuff often. I mean, at video games, I had a dream one time where, after I watched the movie Avatar, that night I went to bed and I was playing Avatar, except for basically it was me living my real life out. I'd play video games, go shoot basketball, except for I was a big blue fucking Smurf guy. You know what I mean? So there's sometimes some weird dreams I have, but this one really, really shook me up the other day. I woke up and I was really, really uncomfortable, emotional, it was weird. And it played out, and then it was another one of those situations that if I thought about it, that's probably how I would have handled it. And I started to think, you know, what happened is the nightmare just kicked off out of nowhere, and I found out I had cancer. I found out it was terminal. I found out that I was so stubborn, which I never go to the doctors, which I don't anyways, that I was too late. I couldn't catch it too long, and I only had like 3 months to live. And I started thinking about what I needed to do to, you know, provide for my son was the priority. My wife and my son, I needed to get them money and take care of them while I was gone. And, you know, so I started thinking of all these random things. What would I do? Would I rob a bank? What would I do to guarantee the future of my happiness and structure for my family? And it felt so real, man. It scared me. And I realized, and things played out. I mean, I went straight to you guys. I went to YouTube and I was like, guys, I've got 3 months to live. I've never wanted your support like this before, but if you guys could like and favorite every video I put out from here, I know it's wrong and I know it's selfish, but it'd get me to the front page every day. I'd have, you know, $100,000 to $200,000 put back. They could buy a house. He'd have his education taken care of. Stuff like that. So it played out and it was scary to know. And I woke up feeling that I lost everything and I was going to die. But after I woke up and I'm like, that's probably how I would have handled it. I probably wouldn't have stolen from anybody, but I would have probably come to you guys. And I thought that's, you know, that kind of taught me, made me think about a few things. The realism, it made me think about how much I care about you guys and how much and how influential you guys are in my life and the responsibility I have to you guys and me trusting you guys enough to ask a favor for you to help my family when I'm going to be gone. And it was so real, it was so emotional. I sat there in front of it and I saw myself. I was watching myself from a weird way, so it wasn't like I was looking at myself, but it was like I was zoned in. I was looking at my monitor. Imagine like you would be watching somebody do this. I was looking at the monitor. Everything you're seeing in front of you is what was on my monitor, except for I was watching myself do this commentary. It was really, really weird. I was crying. I was breaking down. I was begging you guys to do something to help provide for my family while I was gone. And I woke up a wreck, and I wanted to hug my wife, and, you know, those are the kind of things that shake you up. So I wanted to put that out there. I thought it'd be a good commentary. Obviously, I'm not saying that. You guys don't have to like and favorite this video like that. I'm not in danger, guys. I was just letting you know that kind of dream and everything like that and the kind of responsibility and respect I have for what we do. And it was really, really weird. So let me know what you guys think. What's one of your most awkward dreams or scariest nightmares you have ever had? Leave it down in the comments below, guys. Remember to leave a like and favorite, as it does help out a lot. And leave some more commentary topics down below. Just send them my way if you want. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out. Get it.